Welcome to another video from Guelao 60. Today I'm going to be talking about how the Chinese people dealt with this coronavirus and how they came together as one nation of 1.4 billion people to tackle this problem. What I witnessed all the time I was in China during this crisis that China's been dealing with was that everybody in the country was focused, from the police, definitely, tracking down people that might have been exposed to the coronavirus. The medical staff that had to deal with it, but not just the medical staff in Hubei province or Wuhan city, but the medical staff across the country. They were out taking temperatures on highways. Didn't matter the weather. They're out taking temperatures on highways of everybody entering every major city and every town all across the country. There was the mothers that sent their kids to school with masks on and wore masks when they were at the wet markets or the store shopping. The people that worked in the shops in China that helped take temperatures of everybody entering, even the Walmart. You go to Walmart to go get beer like Guelao always does, and they take your temperature before you're allowed in the store. If you go to your local shop, they take your temperature before you enter the shop. Outside our apartment complex, and every apartment complex that I came in contact with over the last 3 or 4 weeks, you had to have your temperature taken before you were even allowed on the property. So all of these people came together in one big community to help each other stem the tide of this coronavirus across China. It went further than that. Every person in the country, like I'm telling you, every person in the country wore a face mask because the government said you should wear a face mask, and so they did. Were they scared? Every person that I knew in China was afraid of catching this virus because they just didn't know what the situation was. And I don't think they still know exactly what the situation was. And they're still scared. I have friends still in China and family still in China that they haven't gone out for a couple of weeks. They are scared to go out. When they do go out, they double mask. They go to the store. They stay away from people. They go to the wet market. They try to stay away from as many people as they possibly can. They get their stuff and they go home and they cook everything way more than they used to. So it's not just the authorities, the politicians, the police, the military, the medical staff, but it even went as far as the restaurants shut down, the KTV shut down, the cinema shut down, all of the places where people come together. Sure, they could open their doors and do probably good business because there's nobody else open, so everybody would have to come to your place. But they didn't. What they did was they took the financial hit because it's, for one thing, better for their health, you know, if you get the virus, and it's better for the country so they can stop the spread of this coronavirus in China. So you have to look at the country as a whole and the people as a whole, as a family, trying to protect each other, trying to protect themselves, trying to protect their children, but most of all, I think they were trying to protect their country. Even the taxi drivers took at least a couple of weeks off because they didn't want to be transporting people around that they didn't know. People coming from the airport, people on the street. And I would imagine that there'd be less people on the street because everybody in the country was self-quarantining themselves. Sure, the government quarantined 60 million people in Hubei province and some other areas actually. Santo in Guangdong province had a quarantine on it for a while because I have a friend in that has a factory in Santo, and he says we're quarantined. He says I can't come home. Oh, okay. Well, so the idea that they self-quarantined themselves because they wanted to assist the Chinese government in dealing with the spread of this coronavirus. So you can't get that in any other country. I'm telling you, if you tried to quarantine the city of New York, the city of Los Angeles, Chicago, Miami, Florida, all of the major cities in the United States, chances are it wouldn't even come to 60 million people. Do you just think the uproar from the people, you're illegally detaining my ass and all this other stuff. See, in China, there was none of that. Everybody just went with the flow, and that's just the way it is. It's a different beast over there, so they just accept it. All public transportation was shut down. The subways were shut down. Interprovincial buses were shut down. Sure, there was a couple city buses still going, but I noticed that there was one or two people on a big city bus at any one time. Planes shut down. There was the whole country basically just stopped everything they were doing to try to stop this virus from spreading. Everybody stopped, right dead in their tracks. I've never seen anything like this in my life, and I probably never will. But everybody has this bad image of the Chinese people, that they are the most patriotic. If you want to see patriotic people, you want to see people that love their country, you want to see people that love their government, all you got to do is look at China, because these people are very straightforward. They know what they want, and they go and get it. And if you want to see a country of brave people, again, all you got to do is look at China, because the people in China took this crisis head on. They dealt with it like no other country could deal with it. And I'm sort of proud to be part of all of this. One of those things that I'll never see again in my life, and nobody will probably ever see anything like this again in their lives. We all hope and pray that this virus is eradicated as fast as possible, or they come up with a vaccine. I heard that the British are working on a vaccine. They figure that they've been able to make they will be able to make something in about 14 days. Whether that's bullshit or not, I don't know, but hey, there's always hope. One thing I do know is that China has gained a lot of respect from lots of countries and organizations around the world on how quickly they dealt with this and how efficiently they dealt with it, and how efficiently they mobilized an entire country to deal with the problem. And as soon as they get this thing under control, my wife Wei Fong and I are going back to Nanning, picking up Mimi at our friend's place, and getting our lives back on track, back to where we were. We were happy, healthy, safe, content, and then all the shit hit the fan, and I just want my China life back. I worry about all those cheap Chinese beers and brandies just sitting there on the shelf, and beer doesn't last forever, and so I'm sort of feeling sorry for them that they can't come and party with Weilao 60 like they expected to be doing all of this time I'm out of the country. Wei Fong was getting pictures and little short videos on WeChat from her friends here over the last 3-4 days, and Nanning is still a ghost city. There is nobody on the streets. It's like a deserted city of 7 million people. I've seen video from Beijing and Shanghai, same thing. Chongqing, same thing. My God, the people are still just self-quarantining themselves. It's amazing. And I think this coronavirus is going to change the way the world actually looks at China and the Chinese people. I'm going to be talking. I'm going to do a video here about the racism that the Chinese people have had to deal with over this last month because of this coronavirus. It's another way to take a jab at the Chinese people. And I'm embarrassed to say it happens in Canada. And that's another video from Weilao 60. If you like this video, as always, like, comment, subscribe, push that share button, and don't forget to hit the bell. Always remember, put a couple bucks in the Patreon account for the children, and thanks for watching. Bye now. Wei Fong, what do you think about the way that the Chinese government and the Chinese people have dealt with the coronavirus? Do you think, that's one question. Another one, do you think it brings them closer together? You think that it makes them more patriotic, love their country more because they're going through something like this together?
Yes, of course. And everybody's stuck very tight together right now. And everybody trying to go through the difficult time for China right now. Because you see, if we stuck together and things are getting easier, if not stuck together, then things fall apart and even worse than you think.
So what do you think about how the government dealt with this?
Very good. Professional, they're more than professional. And you know, just quickly and suddenly happens, and maybe they don't know too good, and then you have to do 1.4 billion, right? People, you have to control them and make them listen to you. And then it's very, very, very difficult. You know, still have some of we call 老鼠屎, and doing the bad job and make things worse. But mostly Chinese is really good. Listen to government and do exactly what they're telling to do.